As I mentioned previously, Candida yeast is a naturally occurring fungus that resides in our intestinal tract, and it's something that we all have. Men, women, young, old, we all have it. And potentially 8 out of 10 people can be affected. In small quantities, it doesn't pose much of an issue. But in larger quantities, it does seem to be able to influence a number of health issues that we had discussed previously. So what causes this fungus to suddenly grow out of control? Experts have potentially identified 6 different causes. The first is diet. As you know, we are a carb-eating society. We love our carbohydrates. From some studies, it shows that we consume upwards of 150 pounds of sugar a year. So do you know what the favorite delicacy of Candida yeast fungus is? Yes, it's carbohydrates. So as we're feeding ourselves carbs, we're feeding our fungus carbs also. So that tends to be a real problem. The second area would be the use of antibiotics. And I know you think that antibiotics are a great medication, and they certainly are. The trouble is that antibiotics do have the potential to contribute to a Candida yeast overgrowth, and let me explain how. Antibiotics, as you know, kill bacteria. They go into your body, they search out the bacteria and eradicate it. The trouble is, in our intestinal tract, we have trillions, yes, trillions of good bacteria. Good bacteria, bacteria that is there for a specific reason. It helps us digest our food, extricate our waste, and it helps keep the Candida yeast fungus under control. So when we take an antibiotic, it goes in, kills bacteria willy-nilly, and it leaves the potential for the Candida yeast to suddenly expand and grow. And as it grows, it contributes to that long list of health issues. The third area is stress. We all have stress in our lives, but when stress reaches a point that it can influence our immune system, again, that can cause the Candida yeast to, or allow the Candida yeast to grow and expand. The fourth area is heredity. I've worked with many people that were part of family units, and they all had a Candida yeast problem. Myself, I can tell you that my father had a severe Candida yeast issue for more than 50 years. Nail fungus, athlete's foot, gas, bloating, and I inherited some of those same issues. So, heredity does play a major part. The fifth area would be sexual contact. It does seem that if somebody has a Candida yeast overgrowth, that they can potentially hand that off to somebody else. I've talked to many, many people that have come to me and said, Mike, you know, I never had these issues before I became intimate with so-and-so. So sexual contact does seem to be one of the things that can influence a Candida yeast problem. And finally, our environment. Warmth and humidity seem to be a big factor in causing Candida yeast to grow and expand. I know in the summertime, we often have an uptick of Candida yeast problems throughout the area. Because if heat and humidity can cause fungus to grow on the outside, they will contribute to Candida yeast fungus growing on the inside of your body.